everyone, it's Tammy, and I am going to do another card using this Tasty Treats Celebration stamp set. I just love it. I think it's so stinking cute. And I think I want to use the taco one this time, and I don't even know. I'm just gonna wing it, because I found this cute paper that I had in my stash. It's actually Stampin' Up! Paper, but it's from many, many moons ago, and it came with matching cardstock. So I cut a 5x5 card, and then I'm going to layer it with this pretty ballet blue color that's no longer available, and then I'm going to put this on top of that. I think this is neat with the little, it has all the little highways and stuff, the little markers. And then I cut this one an inch smaller so that it can go here. So it's a half an inch smaller on each side. Maybe I cut it a half an inch smaller. Sorry, that would make sense. is that right? Or did I cut it an inch? No, I think it is a whole inch smaller, but it's a half an inch on each side. So that's where you can see the little border. And I'm going to put my image on here, and then I have another piece of paper to go on the inside of this 5x5. So let's go ahead and get started. I have my ATG gun here. I'm going to go ahead and put this ballet blue on top of the tan card. I don't remember what color that is. It's one that we has retired. And then I'm going to go ahead and put the cute designer cardstock on top. I'm not going to put this on top yet. I'm going to stamp on that first, but I am going to go ahead and put this on the inside. I mean, honestly, that's cute just like that. That's a really cute card. I'm going to put this up here, so I'll be ready for it, but I'm going to bring my Misty down. Well, I can't get the magnet off. I did my nails not too long ago, so I'm trying to be a little careful with them. I need my taco truck. So how many of you guys have eaten from a food truck before? That's not something that's real common. I mean, I guess it's common here now. It took a while for it to get here. It was not something that we had around. And I've only eaten from one a couple of times. It's not something that we do regularly. I'm going to use the basic gray on this one for no particular reason. I kind of go between the gray and the black. I kind of sometimes like the way the gray looks when I'm using blue. I don't know. And honestly, I can't tell the difference between black and gray on that. I would have, if you wouldn't tell me, I would think it was black. Oh, I need this still open, don't I? And then I use a baby wipe to clean this. And I'll put this back. And then, let's see, I know I need the taco. And what else do I want? I think I can read it better on here. Let's talk about how awesome you are. I think I want the little banner. I think that's cute. And I think I want the, let's go ahead and do the, let's talk about how awesome you are. And that might be it. I thought I wanted, here they are. I was like, I thought I wanted something else. The flags. That's what I wanted. The flags, the flags. So I'm going to put the flags up here, and if I'm careful, I should be able to do, whoops, more than one thing at a time. So that's what I'm going to try to do. That should be good. And then I'll put this banner here in the middle. And I don't know if I'll have room for the taco or not. I might have to do the taco on the next one. Or I could do this up here. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be able to do the taco quite yet, so I'll just leave him up here and then I'll put him where I need him to go when I'm after I get these things stamped. Well, how did that happen? That isn't good. Erg. They stuck together. If you push them apart, that seems to work. Because they're really hard to get unstuck, but I've stuck them together enough times to know the trick. So let me make sure. Yeah. And then I'm just going to stamp these three or ink these three. Just like perfect. Yay. I love that. That's one of the things that's so appealing about the clear stamps. Now, I don't know if you guys have seen the other videos, but if you haven't, then you don't maybe know that this stamp set is free. The only way that you can get it is for free. You can't buy it. So to earn it, you need to purchase $50 or more retail in Stampin' Up! Products, and then you will get a free product from the catalog. There's a celebration catalog that's made just for it. And there's lots of different things to choose from, and this is one of them. And I love it. My favorite is probably the Hey Chick one, but that's only because I call my daughter Chick, and I love that one. So that's probably my favorite one, but this is probably my second favorite. There's so many cute ones, though, it's really hard to say. I think I might even put some tacos on this little strip. Now I want to use blue, and I want to use green, I know for sure, as my two major colors. And I actually think I might have some ballet blue back from the day, so I'm going to take a peek and see if in my stash I have some ballet blue. Form of ink though. Have to clean out my ink drawer to find it. I need to put these in with the other sizes. I'm just trying to keep them apart, and that just didn't work very well. Wow. Well, we'll get there eventually. I'm going to use this one. It's an old Stampin' Up! Pad. And as you can tell, it's called Fiesta, so that will go well with a taco truck, I'm thinking. And then I think I'll get out my, I think I'll do my aqua pen for this. And then I think I might get out my Stampin' markers, maybe. Yeah, let's try. So let's see here. What do I have? What do I have? I'm going to start with this one. And normally I would do this by putting it on the lid, but because this is a multicolored one, I don't really want to do that. So I'm just going right for the ink. And I don't know if you guys remember these multicolored inks, but they still sell them. Stampin' Up! Does it. Stampin' Up! Sells the ombre ones, but we don't have multicolored ink pads anymore, but you can still get them at the craft stores or at Amazon or whatever. But to store them, you keep it like this. If you want to stamp them together, you would move this together and then you can stamp it. But if you stored it like this, the colors start to run. So that's what that is, just so you guys know. And because I'm not using them together, I'm just going to go ahead. Gosh, I have a hair that's was like rubbing on my chest and it was bugging me. Since I'm not going to stamp them together and I'm using them kind of, not kind of, I'm using them as watercoloring, then I am just going straight for the ink. And then I need a scrap piece of paper. I'm pulling one out of my trash. I just have paper trash next to me, so it's not a biggie. Sound good right now? Yes, please. I think I could eat Mexican just about any day, every day, all day. I love Mexican food. Of course, I could probably say that about lots of different food. My husband loves Chinese food. He could probably eat that every day. There are some days that we usually order it from a certain spot and we'll get it like once a week. There are some weeks when, like, if I'm gone or if I go somewhere, he always orders it, like if he's by himself. Unless he cooks something, which is rare. He'll sometimes cook like himself a grilled cheese or something like that, but he doesn't usually cook. He does make really good chicken and dumplings, but he makes a really good mess too. So unless I'm available as well, then I discourage that because I hate coming home to a dirty, dirty kitchen. I mean, he just has flour everywhere and he makes them homemade, which is wonderful. So I can't complain, and I don't, but inside I'm going, oh no. I like how dark green that is. I'm going to see if I can darken up some of this. It's Saturday. Actually, I'm kind of thinking maybe we could go to, I don't know. I haven't made dinner. I haven't like prepared or even thought about dinner yet. It's still early. It's, I don't know, 10 o'clock. So, I don't know. I could either put something in the crock or get something ready. But I was kind of thinking that it might be nice to go to Mexico. Okay, I think I'm going to leave it like that. And then I'm going to color. But I think I'm going to take some of this blue, this really light blue, and just color in the windows. All right. I think I'm done with that. Now I'm going to use my markers. I'm going to use the basic gray. I think that's what this one is. Yes. Oops, I don't want that end. I like the brush end. I'm going to color in this bumper. I don't know what those things are supposed to be. I don't know if they're supposed to be like red. Are they like reflectors or lights? I don't know. Then I think I'll take this. I think it's Delightful Dijon. Yes. And I'm going to do the tacos in this. Just color those in a little bit. And then I'm gonna do some leaves. This is Cucumber Crush. I am using the fine point on this, and I'm just gonna color in like this so it looks like lettuce. And then I was going to use a green to do these awning stripes too, so I think I'll just use this one. And I want the headlight to be yellow, and this is Daffodil Delight. I might color these in. And I'll do the tire in black. I'm going to do a little bit of the ground. I guess I'll do that in a brown color. This one is chocolate chip. Here, let me look at it. I think that's all right. Colors away, aqua marker, throw that back away. Where's my card? Here it is. Let's get some dimensionals. And because this is a different sized card, it's not my standard A2 card, I don't have an envelope for it, so I'm going to have to make one. So I will get out my envelope punch and we will make one of those here in just a second. Okay, for a 5x5 card, it says I need 8 1/4, 8 1/8 by 8 1/8. Well, all of my little 8x8 sheets of paper are right over here, and I'm just gonna go for an 8x8 sheet of paper. Cause an 1/8 of an inch isn't gonna make enough of a mess, and much of a difference for me to change it, frankly. So, I know I like this stack for cards or for envelopes. I think I might use this one right here. So, and this is an 8x8 two-sided paper variety pack. So I'm just using that. Like I said, I know it says to use an 8 1/8 by 8 1/8, but whatever. I'm not listening to it this time. So 5x5. The first score line is at 4 1/8. So I need to get out my scorer, and I need to put this at 4 1/8. Punch and score. And then I move it over, and I don't worry about this anymore. Now I just go with the score line, punch and score. Same here, I don't worry about the measurement. You only use the measurement for the very first line, and then after that you use the score lines. And then we can turn it this way, and this is a corner rounder. And this is not absolutely necessary. You don't have to do the corner rounder if you don't want to. It just kind of makes it a little more professional. Sometimes I'll just do 3 of them, sometimes I'll just do 2 of them. It doesn't really matter. Sometimes I don't do any of them if I just want it pointy. Sometimes it's fun too, like for a Halloween card or something. So I'm going to put this away now, but this is our punch board, or Stampin' Up! Punch board. This actually isn't one from Stampin' Up!, but we sell them. I had that for years prior to me selling Stampin' Up!. But it is nice because you can create any size envelope that you'd like. Now I'm going to make the green on the outside. So I'm just folding this in. Folding this in. I'm just folding them all on the score lines. Thank you. just make sure that it fits, because maybe that eighth of an inch makes a difference. But it does not, so we're good. Okay, so now I'm going to take... I like to use glue. You can use whatever you'd like. And I'm going to put it on the folded sides. And I don't know if you caught that, but see how I glued that one and then I glued this one on top of it? I'm going to do the same thing with this. I'm going to glue this on top of those. And then when it's time to send my card, I will make sure that I write in a dark ink, or I use a white tag or something so that you can see it pretty well. But then when they open the envelope, it's fun on the inside. So I like the double-sided paper. And then this I will just stick right inside. And that will be my card. And then when I'm ready to mail it, I will put glue on this, seal it up. And sometimes I'll put washi on the outside here. And that's that. So thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope that you liked it. I hope that it helped you with something. And take care. Have a great day. Bye-bye.